In 1800, the German naturalist Alexander von Humboldt was watching locals fish for eels in Venezuela when suddenly he saw some eels rise from the water and defend themselves, sending out electric shocks to the fishermen. A strange story, hard to believe, but after 200 years, in 2016, the scientist Kenneth Catania saw this same eel behavior in his laboratory. Man has always known about and taken advantage of biological electricity. Romans cured migraines and even epilepsy by using the torpedo fish. The electric catfish of the Nile was well known to the ancient Egyptians, who used it for treating arthritis. In Victorian times, they even used biological electricity to enliven evenings. Parties were organized where guests would form a chain to experience the shock of an electric fish. There are about 400 known species of fish that can generate or detect electric fields. Scientists have divided them into two main categories based on how much electricity they can generate: weak electrophores and strong electrophores. The elephant fish is a weak electric fish that can produce up to a volt of electricity, which is about two-thirds as much as an AA battery. Through a continuous electric signal, this fish creates a magnetic field, much like a radar, that allows him to detect an obstacle, prey, or even a predator, all while in complete darkness or murky water. But how does biological electricity work? Every cell in living organisms produce a tiny electric charge, pumping positive ions of sodium, potassium, and calcium outside the cell membrane. This is just a normal part of cell biology. So, the outside of cells are slightly positive compared to the insides, and electric fish have evolved organs with hundreds of muscle cells, the electrocyte, which are arranged one above the other in parallel, much like a chain of batteries. When the signal from the brain hits the electrocytes, the pores open up in these cells, allowing those positive ions in. Now, instead of a negative inside and a positive outside, these cells have a negative left side and a positive right side, thus becoming biological batteries. The most powerful electric fish is the electric knife fish, more commonly known as the electric eel. It can release a charge of up to 600 volts, much more than you get from a domestic electric plug. Like the elephant fish, it produces a low electric field to navigate and communicate, but it can strike a high voltage charge for hunting. First, it produces two or three electric charges that stimulate its prey's muscles to go into spasms. Then it uses lower waves to detect where the prey is hiding. One of the most common questions that you're probably wondering about is, why do these fish not electrocute themselves? Well, they do in fact shock themselves. When an eel strikes, you can see it flinch.